Welcome on this tutorial, Wish While You Are Well. I am going to discuss about measurement of pressure. Measurement of pressure is one of the important phenomena in process industries. There are different ways to measure pressure. I will discuss almost all the ways with principle of operation, installation, advantage, limitation, etc. Starting discussion on measurement of pressure. Please subscribe and support me. I will start with why we need to measure pressure. Then I will discuss the definition of pressure, different types of pressure and units of pressure. Next, I will discuss methods of pressure measurement. After that, I will enter the discussion of different types of measurement of pressure one by one. I will discuss pressure measurement by manometer, pressure measurement by elastic type pressure transducer. I will discuss what are the different ways to measure vacuum, what is pressure switch, what is force balance pressure gauge, what are different types of electrical pressure transducer, how the pressure measuring instruments can be calibrated, and also how the maintenance can be done. Why we need to measure the pressure in industry? Almost all industrial processes use liquids, gas, or both. To get particular desired output from process, it requires the measurement and control the pressure of liquid and gas process. So, pressure measurement is one of the most important of all the process measurement and control system. What is the basic definition of pressure? Pressure is force per unit area exerted by a fluid. So, the equation of pressure P is equal to F divided by A, where F is the force and A is the area. In SI system, the unit of force is Newton and unit of area is meter square and the unit of pressure is Pascal. With the start of discussion of pressure measurement, we need to know different definitions related to pressure. First one, static pressure. What is static pressure? When force in a system under pressure is constant or static, means not varying, that pressure is said to be static pressure. Means with respect to time, if the pressure of a particular system is constant, then that pressure is termed as static pressure. What is dynamic pressure? If the pressure is varying with respect to time, the pressure is said to be dynamic pressure. Next, coming to absolute pressure. What is absolute pressure? Absolute pressure is a pressure that is relative to the zero pressure in the empty air-free space of the universe. This reference pressure is the ideal or absolute vacuum. When the pressure will be measured with respect to zero reference, then that pressure is normally termed as absolute pressure. Absolute pressure is sum of the gas pressure and the atmospheric pressure. So, we can say absolute pressure is equal to gas pressure plus atmospheric pressure. Now, what is gas pressure? Gas pressure is the pressure relative to atmospheric pressure. Means, when any pressure will be measured with respect to atmospheric pressure, then that pressure is termed as gas pressure. Gas pressure is positive for a pressure above atmospheric pressure and negative for a pressure below it. So, we can say gas pressure is equal to absolute pressure minus of atmospheric pressure. Next, what is vacuum? When absolute pressure is less than atmospheric pressure, or in other words, the gas pressure is negative, then it is called vacuum. See, if this P absolute is less than P atmosphere, then P absolute minus P atmosphere, no doubt a negative term. When this became negative, then this gas pressure is normally called as vacuum. Another term is associated here, that is differential pressure. Differential pressure is the pressure which is the difference between two pressures. Whenever we measure some quantity, always we measure it with respect to some reference level. In this case, we are going to measure the pressure and say the reference level is this one. Say we are measuring a particular pressure with respect to zero reference. This is zero reference and this is the pressure. So this is the amount of pressure. Now if we change the reference, say we are going to measure same pressure with respect to a reference, and that reference is 1 atmosphere. See, this is 1 atmospheric pressure. From here to here, this vertical line indicates 1 atmospheric pressure. Now if that pressure is measured with respect to this atmospheric pressure, then that pressure will be this one, this red color vertical line. Say this pressure is 5 unit when we are measuring with respect to zero reference. Now same pressure, same indication is say 4 unit when we are measuring the same pressure with respect to atmospheric pressure. When the indication will be 5 unit, then indication is absolute pressure, and when the indication is 4 unit, that measurement is the indication in gauge pressure. While we will discuss the measurement of pressure in different process fluid, several times we will use measurement of pressure with the equation H into rho into G. Now here I want to discuss whether this H rho G is gauge pressure or absolute pressure. Say this is a particular container. In this container some fluid is there. Fluid is any type of liquid. Now what will be the pressure at the bottom surface? The pressure at the bottom surface P will be equal to force divided by area. Now what is the force? Force is nothing but the weight of this amount of fluid. If the weight W is equal to M into G, then the pressure will be mg divided by A. Now what is this mass? We can calculate this mass with respect to density and volume. Mass is equal to rho into V, where rho is the density of this fluid and V is the volume of this fluid. So ultimately mass is equal to rho into A into H. So the equation of this pressure P will be mg divided by A is equal to rho AHG divided by A is equal to H into rho into G. So the pressure at the bottom of this container created by this amount of fluid is equal to H into rho into G, where H is the height of the fluid. This pressure is due to the weight of fluid only. So in this case, we have considered only the force created by this fluid in downward direction. But above this fluid, there is some atmospheric pressure. Till now, we have not included this atmospheric pressure while we were calculating pressure at the bottom of the surface. So when we are considering this atmospheric pressure, the pressure P will be P atmospheric pressure plus H into rho into G, where PA or P atmospheric pressure is the pressure above the surface of this fluid, and H rho G is the pressure created by H height of the liquid. So from this equation, we can get H rho G is equal to P minus PA. Means this H rho G pressure is the pressure with respect to atmospheric pressure. P minus PA, it indicates that H rho G is the pressure which has been calculated with respect to atmospheric pressure, not considering the zero reference. So no doubt H rho G is the gauge pressure. H rho G indicates about the gauge pressure. Now I want to discuss what is the SI unit of H rho G. SI unit of H rho G is Pascal. Now we need to know how unit of H rho G is Pascal. To get it, we should know what is the definition of Pascal. Pascal is a pressure of unit and Pascal is equal to Newton per meter square. How the unit of h rho g will be Pascal? I am explaining it here. H is the height. In SI system, unit of this height is equal to meter. Rho is the density. In SI system, unit of this rho is kg per meter cube. G is the acceleration due to gravity. Unit of the g is meter per second square. So from this we need to find ultimately in Pascal. Now this is the definition of Pascal. Here I am trying from this term whether we can come to Pascal or not. See here, at numerator here it is m square, at denominator it is m cube. So it will be 1 by m. The rest thing is kg per second square. Say this term, kg by m s to the power 2. Now from here we need to bring this term. I am doing back calculation. What is Newton? Newton is force. What is force? We know the equation P is equal to m into f, where P is the force, m is the mass, f is the acceleration. In SI system, m is kg. What is f? Acceleration, which is nothing but meter per second square. So in place of Newton, I am writing here kg meter per second square. And denominator there was a m square. Now see what is here. Here it is kg by m s to the power 2. We need kg m divided by m square s 2. So what we need? At denominator we need m square. Here it is only a single m. So what we can do? We can multiply both sides by a m. So ultimately multiplying this, we get this term kg m divided by m square s to the power 2. From here, this kg m s square, this part is the force. So I have written here kg m divided by s square and rest part is 1 by m square. Now this kg m by s square, this is nothing but the force, which is Newton in SI system. This Newton multiplied by 1 by m square, that is Newton per meter square, which is nothing but Pascal. So I think it is clear how the unit of h rho g in SI system is Pascal. By this way we can find unit of pressure in other system also. Next, coming different units of pressure. While we discuss about the measurement of pressure, then we need to know the different units which are normally used to identify a particular pressure. There are so many units and the relation between those units are very difficult to remember. See from here, this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 means 9 into 9, that is 81 relations are here. See, 1 Pascal is equal to what will be the value of atm. 1 psi is equal to what will be the value of kg per centimeter square, like this. So these are different units: bar, Pascal, atm, psi, kg per centimeter square, feet, water column, millimeter of mercury, like this. So there are so many units and it is very difficult to remember what are the relations between different units. Here I have written relation of few units, and if we can remember these few units, means here only 5 or 6 numbers of relations are here. If we can remember this 5 or 6 numbers of relation, then any relation between any two units we can find from these few relations. What are the relations here I have written? 1 atm is equal to 14.7 psi, which is nothing but 1.013 into 10 to the 5 newton per meter square, which is nothing but 1.01325 into 10 to the 5 pascal, 1 newton per meter square is equal to pascal. Now there is a relation between newton and dyne. 1 newton is equal to 10 to the 5 dyne. So from here it will come 1.013 into 10 to the 6 dyne per centimeter square. Similarly, 1 atmospheric pressure is equal to 760 millimeter of Hg. Now 1 millimeter of Hg is equal to 1 torr. So it can be defined as 760 torr. Similarly, 1 atmosphere pressure is equal to 1.013 kg per centimeter square, which is nothing but 1.0325 bar, which is nothing but 1.03 into 10 to the 3 centimeter water column, which is nothing but 1.03328, that is the technical atmospheric unit. So if we remember these few relations, then we can define any relation between any two units. See, I am giving one example from this chart. See the relation in between psi and this pascal. Say I am considering this value. This is the value with the relation psi unit and pascal unit. On psi is equal to 6894.8 pascal. From that chart which I have written, I am trying to find this one. On psi is equal to how much pascal. See here, which one is psi, this one is psi, which one is pascal, this one is pascal. So 14.7 psi is equal to 1.01325 into 10 to the 5 pascal. On psi will be this divided by 14.7. I am doing it. This is 1.01325. So 1.01325 divided by 14.7. How much? This is 6892 point something. See the value in that chart. The value is 6894. So we got the relation. No need to remember this chart. So by this way, if we try to remember these relations only, from these relations we can find any relation between any two units in pressure. What are the different methods of pressure measurement we will discuss in this series of pressure measurement discussion? There are liquid column method, normally it is termed as manometer. There are elastic element method, which are diaphragm, Bourdon tube and bellows. There are electrical method like strain gauge, piezoelectric, piezoresistive. There are different methods to measure vacuum, which are macleod, Pirani, ionization. I will discuss all these types of pressure measuring system one by one. This was introductory part of discussion on pressure measuring system. Here I have discussed how pressure is defined, what is the equation of pressure and what are the different units of pressure. What is static pressure? What is dynamic pressure? What are absolute pressure, gauge pressure and vacuum pressure? And what are the relationship among these three? What are the different units of pressure and how we can easily remember the relationship between two units of pressure among all the units? What are the different types of pressure measurement system? In next tutorial, I will enter into the discussion on manometer. Please subscribe and put your comments in comment section.